The reason I'm disappointed is because the status quo is not an option. Obamacare is not working. We've got dozens of counties around America that have zero insurers left. So doing nothing really isn't an option.
That's House Speaker Paul Ryan on the attack against Obamacare during a town hall meeting that aired this week. The lawmaker cites the lack of coverage in some counties as a reason to repeal and replace the Affordable Care Act. But as of yesterday, an Ohio insurer stepped in to cover the last so-called bear county, the last county in the country that was offering no policies under Obamacare. So everyone has at least one insurer selling Obamacare policies next year. Joining us now to discuss, Cabot Phillips, media director for campusreform.org and a former digital director for Marco Rubio's presidential campaign. Wendy Osefo is a liberal political commentator and a public affairs professor at Johns Hopkins University. If you read the papers, Cabot, a lot of people suggest that, see, Obamacare is working because now every county has coverage. What do you make of that argument?
Well, 8 years ago, Obamacare was sold to the American people with lies, and now it's being defended and propped up with more lies. Remember the promise, if you like your plan, you can keep your plan. Now Democrats are having to say, if you don't like our plan, well, you're out of luck. You can't have any other plan. And how ironic is it that the Democrats now celebrating, look, everyone has a plan now. Well, why was there so much trouble in getting insurers to come into these districts and cover people? It's because these crippling Obamacare mandates and regulations kept insurers out of the marketplace. And that's not sustainable. This is not something, people don't have the options they deserve. And people are now having to defend it with lies. They're not actually giving anyone affordable options that cover them. They're just giving them a one size fits all, basically a Medicaid policy. And that's hurting American people.
Wendy, is the fact that every county has one coverage choice at least, is that something to be rejoiced?
Absolutely. What we have to understand is that our policymakers have to start being honest. And what Speaker Ryan did was intellectually dishonest. We all know that the Trump administration deliberately drove out insurance to make room for Trump care. Furthermore, Speaker Ryan said dozens of bear patches were there. At the time he said that, there were only two bear patches. Fast forward 4 days, there are no bear patches. So what we have here is a rhetoric that is failing. Obamacare is not failing. The case against it from the GOP is what's failing. The GOP has to put aside this pervasive narrative and start working in a bipartisan manner with Democrats across the aisle to now start fixing what is wrong with the Affordable Care Act. What they cannot do is say we're going to repeal it. Instead, they should turn to fixing what is wrong.
But Wendy, there were insurers dropping out of the exchanges well before President Trump took office.
Yes, there were. Because again, like I just said, there are issues with the Affordable Care Act, but it's not beyond fixing. It's something that we can fix. And I think that Congress really needs to turn its sights on fixing what's wrong instead of trying to repeal it and make it so that 22 million Americans, if not more, will go without insurance. And that's the big issue here. We have to do what's best for the American people. And it's not to repeal Obamacare. It's to fix any of the glitches that may be present.
We talk about misleading rhetoric. That 22 million number, do you know how many millions of those people are only going to be losing their insurance because they would choose not to have insurance and they're forced to have insurance right now because of the Obamacare mandate? In 2013, the average American family was paying $2,700 for their mandate. And now, in 2017, it's $5,700 a year the average American is paying for their health care. It's absolutely ridiculous. The prices are, it's not sustainable, and it is misleading to try and twist what the CBO score is saying of the Republican plan. Yes, it needs to have improvements across the board, but we can't let the failure of Republicans in the House and Senate this year take us away from the fact that they still need to get repeal done and keep their promise to voters, or get out and get someone in office that's actually going to pass meaningful repeal.
Well,
Cabot, that's not true.
All right. Go ahead, Wendy.
No, I was going to say, Cabot, that's not true. I think we need to focus on what Speaker Ryan just said a few days ago. He said that there's several dozen bear patches, and this is that rhetoric I'm talking about. It's a pervasive rhetoric. It's misleading the American people. I am all for fixing Obamacare. I am not saying that it's 100% perfect. No, there are pivots that need to be made. But we cannot use this language that makes it seem like we are dealing with something that's completely wrong or something that's nefarious in nature. It's not. There were only two bear patches, and we need to come together in a bipartisan, that is the key word here, bipartisanship, to fix anything that is wrong.
If, you know, it's, I guess you can't put the toothpaste back in the tube, but if Obamacare had never been passed, would there have been any bear patches?
We're celebrating, the Democrats are celebrating fixing a problem that only exists because they created it in the first place. That's a very interesting strategy. It would almost be comical if it wasn't hurting so many Americans in the first place.
Oh, there's nothing comical about this, Cabot. There's people losing their lives. There's people dying. And so, again, we don't need to make light of what's going on here. We really need to come together in a bipartisan way.
No, absolutely not. I think we can all agree that it's ridiculous, though, that the left is celebrating covering everyone when
agree.
The people were only uncovered because of failed Democrat policies in the first place. You can't celebrate fixing a problem that's only there because you created it.
It does seem, Wendy, that having, you know, one insurer who is getting government subsidies or government subsidized policies to help keep it in place, that's hardly a victory, is it?
No, that's not a victory, and I think that that's actually problematic, if you want me to be quite honest. We need to have more than one insurer because that tilts the market in a way that we don't want to start setting a precedent for again. But, you know, we cannot have the GOP trying to choke out the market either and refusing to give money so this medical assistance can move forward. That's an issue as well. So, again, it's important that we come together. It's important that we do this in a bipartisan manner, but we cannot choke out the market. The insurers need help. And this instability is coming from the instability overall from Congress. What are insurers supposed to do? So they're pulling out preemptively.
Some of it's coming from the insurance companies who find they were not able to be profitable under the Obamacare regulations. So you have to own up to that as well.
Absolutely. That's one of the fixes that we have to make. I agree with that.
All right. Wendy Acefo, Cabot Phillips, thank you both. Good discussion.
Thank you.